The family of Jacob Blake and Breonna Taylor, they have been arrested. They have been arrested. Let me take you to the video. Here it is.
Go! Keep watching him! Leave! Touch him! Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? That's the family of Breonna right there.
You guys take it on the sidewalk. What are we doing? Why are we still attacking people? Y'all take it on the sidewalk.
He's handicapped. That's Jacob Blake Sr. That's Jacob Blake Sr. You know who that is, right? Okay, I'm going. I'm pressed, you dumb bitch. I'm pressed. That's Jacob Jacob Blake Sr. She can't do anything, you guys. She's stuck. Man, you guys.
Tragic. Let's put up both of their pictures. I'm going to give you the background as to what happened here. During a protest, protesting the police killing of Jayland Walker. We've been talking about this all week in Ohio. Relatives of black people who have been harmed or killed by the police were taken into custody, which includes Breonna Taylor's aunt, Bianca Austin, and Jacob Blake's father, Jacob Blake Sr. All right. The Akron Police Department carried out these arrests. According to the Twitter used that tweeted the video we just saw, they stated in the tweet, 7622. The moment the police moved in, Bianca Austin was manhandled. Me and Cortez Rice were bare maced. Activist Pressure was assaulted. He had his head slammed on the ground, the truck, and was punched by cops. And Jacob Blake Sr. was pinned. Hashtag Jayland Walker. This is from the Family Soups TV Twitter account. Now, literally, you have individuals who have suffered significant loss and damage, hurt, pain because of law enforcement. And what are they doing with that energy? They are literally coming to the rescue of others throughout this country in order to provide connection, in order to provide solidarity. And what happens? They get arrested in the most violent of ways. There's more to this story. Blake Sr. and Austin traveled together to Ohio through Families United, a group seeking greater accountability for police brutality and shootings. Blake Sr.'s family member, Justin Blake, said, Families United was founded by Blake Sr. and Austin to also give families who have gone through the shock and trauma, mental support and help with lawyers and the law. Very noble, right? They were sitting together in a van when they witnessed a man being punched in the face by police during the protest. That's according to Justin Blake. They both got out of the vehicles to question the police before they were confronted by officers, Justin Blake said. They were down there supporting the family and the community when this thing occurred and when the brutality turned on them. Blake Sr. was severely beaten by officers and WSA transported to a hospital in police custody, according to political activist Fred Hampton. All right, there's more. Several people were taken into custody as police said anyone downtown during the protest would be subject to arrest. So this is them enforcing some ridiculous curfew. The municipal court records confirmed Jacob Blake Sr. was arrested on four counts. Here are the four counts: riot, resisting arrest, failure to disperse, and disorderly conduct. Bianca Austin, Taylor's aunt, was charged with 3 counts: riot, failure to disperse, and disorderly conduct. Austin is currently a confirmed inmate at Summit County Jail, while Blake Sr. is still at the hospital. And a bench warrant has been issued for his arrest while he is at the hospital. Okay, let's put up these pictures, all right? This is interesting here. This type of treatment from that local police department is not new. It has now been reported that some of the members of the police force are members of a white supremacist gang known as Tango 22. That has been reported. So you have this screenshot from Baby the Divine Twitter account highlighting this dynamic. Jamie Sugar and Nathaniel Milstead, both of STOW, were united in marriage June 25th at the Martin Luther Lutheran Church in Youngstown. All right. He is a police officer with that police department, the Akron Police Department, and a member of the SWAT team. Okay. And there's more information online making these connections. It is fascinating. It is fascinating that every witness who has gone on record has said that what happened to the family, what happened to these individuals, was not legal at all. Do you find it ironic that they were targeted in this way, that they were handled in this way? This is a protest about police brutality, and they were brutalized by the police. All right, we're going to continue to follow this story, obviously. Ben, what are your thoughts on this case?
Yeah, I mean, I can't help but connect this to what I've seen in Minneapolis, because the reality is, right, like when they were shouting the names of these folks and saying that they were like, you know, the family members of people who had previously been like killed by police officers, I think the police officers took that as an opportunity to explicitly target them. I would even put money on police officers knowing in advance that they were going to be there and wanting to go out of their way to target these individuals in particular, because look, I've seen this in Minneapolis. When you have city council members in Minneapolis that talk about, you know, even just changing police funding, you have reports of police officers who are saying that they're not going to go into their districts. And then, of course, when the protests were happening after George Floyd was killed, there were literally city council members on the ground who were part of the protests, which were peaceful, by the way. Right. And you had police officers bumping up against them, making pretty threatening gestures, and then later that night, quite literally firing tear gas directly in their direction when they were obviously within eye shot. They know what they're doing, right? This is an act of intimidation, right? This is in my opinion, this is a threat from the police department to anybody who would dare challenge their unquestioned authority to commit brutal acts of violence with impunity.
Well said.